Given f of x equals x raised to the power of 2x, we want to find f prime of x, the derivative of f of x, and f prime of 1. To find our derivative function, we're going to perform logarithmic differentiation. So for the first step, we'll substitute y for f of x, so our function is y equals x to the power of 2x. And now to perform log differentiation, the first step is to take the natural log of both sides of the equation. Now we want to expand the right side of the equation as much as possible, which means we can use the power property of logarithms to move the exponent to the front so that we have a product of the exponent and natural log x. So now we would have natural log y equals 2x times natural log x. And now we'll differentiate both sides of the equation with respect to x. To differentiate natural log y with respect to x, we'll perform implicit differentiation, which means since this function is in terms of y, not x, we'll have an extra factor of dy dx from the chain rule. So the derivative of natural log y with respect to x would be 1 over y times dy dx. And on the right side, in order to find this derivative, we'll have to apply the product rule. If we need to review, the product rule is given here, where the derivative of f times g with respect to x is equal to f times g prime plus g times f prime. So in this case, f would be equal to 2x and g would be equal to natural log x. So the derivative is equal to the first function, 2x, times the derivative of the second function, which is the derivative of natural log x, plus the second function, which is natural log x, times the derivative of the first function, which is 2x. Now we'll go ahead and find these two derivatives. So we have 1 over y times dy dx equals 2x times the derivative of natural log x with respect to x, which would just be 1 over x, plus natural log x times the derivative of 2x, which would just be 2. Let's go ahead and find these products. We have 1 over y times dy dx equals, notice these x's would simplify out, we just have 2 plus, this would be 2 natural log x. And now to solve this for dy dx, we'd have to multiply both sides of the equation by y. So we'd have dy dx equals y times the quantity 2 plus 2 natural log x. So this is our derivative function, but usually if we can, we want to write this in terms of just x, not x and y. And since y, or our function, is equal to x raised to the power of 2x, we'll substitute x to the power of 2x for y on the next slide. So again, we substituted x to the power of 2x for y. So this is our derivative function. Let's go ahead and distribute this. So we have dy dx equals 2 times x to the power of 2x plus 2x to the power of 2x natural log x. Remember, we were also asked to find f prime of 1. So f prime of 1 is going to be equal to dy dx evaluated at x equals 1. So we'd have 2 times 1 to the power of 2 times 1, that's 2, plus 2 times 1 to the power of 2 times natural log 1. But natural log 1 is equal to 0. So this simplifies to 0. So f prime of 1 is equal to positive 2, which if we graph the function, would be the slope of the tangent line at x equals 1. So before we look at the graph, again, here was our derivative function, f prime of x or dy dx, and here's f prime of 1. So if we take a look at the graph of the original function, f of x, here's the point on the function when x equals positive 1. And if we sketch a tangent line at that point, it would look something like this. And since f prime of 1 was equal to positive 2, we know the slope of this tangent line at that point is positive 2. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.